Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's Lejeune here. I'm now back at it with another video. And as you guys see in today's video, we will be talking about how we may be able to see Black Panther sooner than we expected. Now, before we get into the video, if you guys go to enjoy it and you like it, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell as well, so you don't miss a video and always be notified when I upload a video. And most importantly, make sure you guys hit that like button. Now, without further ado, let's run my intro. Now, you may have clicked on this video wondering on how we're going to be seeing Black Panther sooner than we expected. Now, we have two teasers so far when it comes to Black Panther in the game right now when it comes to Marvel's Avengers. Now, the first one is when they first showed off the Future Imperfect DLC with the Kate Bishop War Table. If you remember, at the end of the War Table, they teased Future Imperfect, basically showing Maestro, and as you see on the throne with Maestro, you were able to see Black Panther's helmet. And that was the first ever tease for Black Panther in the game. Now, I do want to take that back because they was going to show Black Panther on the War Table when the game released, but you know, due to Chadwick, his passing, they didn't show it. So I want to correct myself in that. I was just watching the edit and I just saw that I said that. So, you know, let's get back to the video. And then for the second one, which was like a couple days ago, which was the Hawkeye teaser poster with the Future Imperfect. And we have another picture of Black Panther's helmet on the ground as well as another, as a trophy for Maestro. So this is what's heavily influenced my theory, I guess you could say, when it comes to seeing Black Panther sooner than we expected. Now, I have two scenarios on how this will go down for us seeing Black Panther for the first time in Marvel's Avengers. Now, for the first one is a Maestro cutscene, basically just showing off what Maestro, like how everything went down with the nuclear war and everything, then him going to fight the Avengers, because as you know, he did defeat all the Avengers because he has trophies for them. So we probably might see a cutscene of Maestro just basically explaining how everything went down and how, you know, how he has all the Avengers trophies and everything, how he defeated them. And possibly through that cutscene, because Black Panther's helmet is in that on the trophies of the enemy of the Avengers he had defeated, Black Panther's helmet is a part of that. So if they show the cutscene of Maestro fighting the Avengers, we might get our first exclusive look at Black Panther in the game. Now, of course, they might not do this. They might not go this route. They might like blur him out. You might like see like a figure of Black Panther, but we probably won't see his costume officially, something like that. So that could be a huge possibility of something happening like that, because of course not everyone knows about Maestro, because you know, people, they're not comic book head like us, because we know who Maestro is. He's basically Bruce Banner in a Hulk body with the strength of Hulk and the intellect of Hulk. So he's a very powerful Hulk. Not a lot of people know about him. So if they go this route and just basically do like a back, you know, like a cutscene of where everything leading up to Maestro being powerful and how he has all the Avengers trophies, I can see this possibly being the first time we ever see Black Panther in the game. And now for the second scenario that I feel like how we might end up seeing Black Panther as well is, if you remember at the end of Kate Bishop's DLC, right, how they teased with, you know, Hawkeye with basically him going into like a coma, a tachyon coma, I guess you could say, and him basically, you know, just setting up the Kree invasion and basically the next DLC Future Imperfect. So you see how they set that up, right? Now, I feel like at the end of Hawkeye's DLC, when they finally, you know, resolve everything dealing with Maestro and Future Imperfect, when that is done, as you know, I feel like since they have the knowledge of the Kree invasion that is upcoming, that, you know, with the world basically ended somewhat, because as you see in the Kate Bishop DLC, the world is kind of messed up. It's a lot of Kree sentries around. They had the Kree ship and everything. It was looking bad. So with the knowledge that they have right now for the Kree invasion, I feel like they will go to Wakanda to, you know, basically recruit T'Challa to basically get them on his side, get, you know, him on their side, so they can have the resources and just have the military offensive technology for, you know, getting ready for this Kree invasion. And that will be, you know, probably go into the Black Panther DLC, having, you know, what is going on with Black Panther going on, and that's how I feel like that's going to lead on to that one. So hopefully that end up coming true. I feel like the second one sounds more, you know, more real, if I'm being honest, if I'm being real, But then again, the first one could be true of us seeing like a cutscene of Maestro basically just explaining how everything went down, him defeating the Avengers, and basically us getting our first look of Black Panther. But let me know in the comments, what do you think about this theory I have set up? What do you think about the first one with the Maestro cutscene and the second one with the end of the, you know, the DLC for Hawkeye? We will be going, basically just, they'll say they'll be going to Wakanda to recruit Black Panther, you know, just getting upcoming for the Kree invasion that is coming. So let me know in the comments what you think about that. That's my little theory when it comes to that. I really, really, really do feel like these two can be a really huge possibility. At the end of the day, we don't know. This is a theory that I've come up, but let me know in the comments. Now, as you guys know, this is the end of today's video. It was a short video, I know. It's basically like my theory out, to be honest. Now, if I was rude, if I was just, you know, rude and everything, I would literally extend it, but I don't feel like that's really the point of really doing things. But I wanted to get this out there, get my theory to you guys. But yeah, that's the end of today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. But before we head out, if you guys are not, make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to turn on post notifications so you don't miss a video, and always be notified when I upload a video. And most importantly, make sure you guys hit that like button. Now, if you guys don't know as well, I do have a Discord. Go over everything that on Marvel's Avengers, Gotham Knights, other games as well. We do have variety. So if you guys want to join that, the link is below for my Discord. And also, I do stream on Twitch. Now, I'm recording this on the 31st. We're basically like 2 weeks away, if I'm correct, from Hawkeye's War Table. So if you guys want to come out to that, my Twitch stream is below. I will be live streaming that, and I will be live streaming in general. So if you guys want to come out to that, the Twitch link will be below as well. And also, I want to give a quick shout out to the memberships on the channel. Shout out to everyone that's a membership. I really, really appreciate it. Shout out to the Elite Avengers and the Rookie. Shout out to y'all. I really, really appreciate it. But yeah, it's LeJune here. I really hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe, and have a good day. Peace.